Chief. You can follow me at IG at They Call Me Chief.
And it's your favorite great this guy, Jimm.
I said that all along.
It's your favorite great guy, Jimm. And you guys can follow me on everything followable. This guy, Jimm, J-I-M-M. It's two M's because there's a lot of Jimms in the world with one. So, yeah, just follow me and see my life.
Anyway, man, shout out to Elevate ATL. I was there this past, I want to say Friday. It was so much fun. It was, the theme is F-I-L-A, Forever I Love Atlanta. B.O.B. was a headliner. Hey. Scotty ATL was out there.
You know, you was having fun on your Instagram pics.
I was.
She was chilling around the celebs thinking she was somebody.
Well, I am a somebody. Everybody's a somebody. But you know, it was cool. It was real fun. I was turned. I was very drunk.
Hey, as you should be. Don't be very drunk, but you know.
No, I mean, like, it wasn't to a point where I didn't know what I was doing.
Oh, that's what? Be controllably drunk.
No, but I'm saying, I knew what I was doing.
She was Lucy drunk.
Yeah, I was just like, hey, girl, you look cute. Even though she wasn't cute type of drunk.
You were cute. You looked really good that day.
Thanks.
You guys heard that day. She's cute every day.
Whatever. And you can follow SnapClique IG. This is a cameraman, and make sure y'all subscribe to our YouTube page at The Faded Radio Show.
Yeah.
You can Google us now. I just realized that.
Hey, we better be on Google.
Yeah, you should have seen my reaction. I was like, like, I almost choked on the goddamn air. Like, I was like, oh, shit, we made it.
That was some southern shit. Choked on the goddamn air.
Anyway, we got a special guest. His name is Ponybody. He's coming up a little bit later. Of course, we got the hot topics for y'all.
Got some castings. We got some higher use and get job stuff and some daily life tips that I think you might need.
For real? You like, on the phone, you sound like you have something to say.
Look, I got a lot to say today. So, yeah.
You been holding in?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There's walls with no holes because I've been holding it in.
Alright, well, before we get into a music break, I have to ask this question. And for all those who want to answer the question, the number is 404-334-0380-404-334-0380. And so the question is, what is the most common thing you lie about?
Oh.
You hit it with the bomb.
Let's say the most common thing I lie about is my phone, forgetting to text back. Because sometimes, I'm real absent-minded when it comes to my phone. My phone could be in my hand all day, and like, I'll get a text randomly, and I might be watching a movie or something, and just like, not text back, and then forget, and then tomorrow I'm like, oh shit, I forgot to text Evie back.
And what, you lie and say, oh, I didn't get it?
Yeah.
Okay,
or like, I think my phone was dead. I'm dead, man. I didn't have service.
I don't know. I would say I probably lie about, there's so much, like, whatever, I just hate talking about this,
there's
but,
so
like,
much. No, I'm, no, 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 I'm sweating for her.
No, like, it's not, like, I mean, it's, I don't lie about a lot, but it's, like, it's a white lie. Like, what's a white lie?
What,
like,
defines a white lie? Yeah.
Like, it's not detrimental to your health, like, wealth, or being.
Like, for, like, a fat woman, if you're like, hey, look at you looking all
okay,
nice.
okay, that's a good lie. Common lie I lie about at work is, oh, you look good in that.
Yeah. Okay, well, if that's the case, I give out little white lies to everybody because I feel like sometimes people need a compliment, whether or not it matters or not. It might, you know, lift their spirits.
Right. And then I used to lie about sex, but then I just realized it's so much better to tell the truth.
You should, because it might make the person better.
Or it could just crush them for life.
I mean, sometimes you got to hear it.
So would you want somebody to tell you?
Absolutely. Tell me what I did wrong and I'll work on it.
What if they said, like, oh, you know, I don't know, I just imagine it'd be so much better.
And I'll just be like, damn, so did I. So what do I got to work
on? What if they were good? So you're going to sit there and be defensive?
If they were good, I'm going to be like, you're good. If you're bad, I'm just going to say, you know, I mean, knowing me, because I'm a dickhead, I might say, oh, you know, I've had better, but it was good for you. It was good, you know. Ended with a white lie, it was good.
to give him an extra boost. That's some bullshit. See, what's the most common thing you lie about?
Real niggas don't lie, B.
Nah, listen, you can't cop out. Somebody, you have to, like, okay, there's never been.
I'm not copping out.
I mean, real niggas lie.
You have to lie sometimes. There's some situations where you just, like, call
if
for
the
you.
The pulls up and said, you.
Yeah.
You can lie to the cops.
Okay, so that's a common lie. I don't have weed.
No, I don't have weed.
Yeah, that's going to be CM's common lie. I don't have weed.
It's just my air freshener.
All right, man, we're about to get into a music break real quick. Shout out to Snoop Dogg. Snoop Doggy Dogg. Happy birthday to you. And shout out to everybody tuning in. Of course, we got these hot topics for y'all. find out who's in trouble, find out who's not in trouble, and find out everything else. Mm-hmm. It's your it's your favorite homegirl, DJ Chief, Fader Radio. What's up? Yo, 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 what up, what up, what up? It's your favorite homegirl, Chief.
She's always trying to sing it. But yeah, I'm the greatest guy, Jimm, guys, because I'm awesome and I'm great.
Well, you didn't have to explain it. They would have just known.
I mean, if they didn't know that, they do.
Okay, so I guess you told the world.
I'm awesome.
You can follow me at They Call Me Chief, and you can also follow our production at SnapClique IG, and click is spelled C-L-I-Q-U-E.
Usually there's a lot of them in the room when they come, so make sure you got a lot of space. But today we just got one, the most important one, Mr. Snap himself.
Can we get a clap of song?
Hey. I'll do the crowd.
All right, we got Turn Up in the building.
What up, party people? I apologize for my lateness. You know, Atlanta freeway wanted to have its time of the month.
Yeah, it never wants to work with us.
It never, especially, yeah.
And
it was
crazy.
What?
You know what? How I feel about being late? It's good to be on time to important things, but when you matter, you're the star, so you're good.
Gee, thanks, yeah. Jimm.
What the fuck is wrong with you, man? He's like Socrates of the hood. Anyway, all right, so Turn Up, where can we follow you at?
You can follow me on everything followable. Turn Up, T-U-U-R-N-U-U-P. And on Snapchat, just put a DJ in front of it. And good.
And shout out to CM the DJ and everybody else at Highly Unique Radio. Definitely. All right, so we about to get into these hot topics real quick. And before we do, make sure y'all stay tuned and keep this number locked.
404-334-0380
again. 404-334-0380. We got Poe Nevada coming through. He's a hot artist in these Atlanta streets, performing everywhere. But anyway, so the first story and hot topic.
Where's he performing?
He's performing everywhere.
Everywhere.
That's like so much. All right, so y'all know Bobby Shmurda is still in jail, right? Or prison, really.
Clearly.
Alright, so pretty much everybody's pretty much asking why hasn't his label, Epic Records, gotten, or you know who the CEO is, L.A. Reid.
Yeah.
How come they haven't posted his bail, which is $2 million? And so, do y'all believe this? But L.A. Reid had said that pretty much they don't have the same money like they used to, and we just can't afford to pay.
What record label is
this? Epic Records.
Damn.
Right, but he was getting so much money off of that one single.
Off that one single.
Right. And then, but you know, and then his bail got denied 3 times and he won't go to jail until, I mean, he won't go to trial until February 22nd.
Damn, so he's going to sit there.
Yes.
Oh, sad guy.
That is so crazy.
Yep, but you know, he has no longevity in his career, so that's why they keep him in there.
Damn.
You don't feel like kicking one is down.
Somebody throw the shots.
I mean, I'm saying, I mean, where do you see him in 5 years?
I mean, well, by this rate, he's probably still going to be sitting there.
Exactly. It's only more shots to me, but anyway.
I don't know. Y'all, you shit.
Hey, if you got the talent, go for the dream.
Y'all hating. I mean, I hate that.
I mean, hey, I mean, I love when I'm proven wrong. That happened with Future. I did not think it was going to last as long. But I love when I'm proven wrong.
Okay. Dre is getting sued by his former highly paid housekeeper who said she was harassed at work. So pretty much her name was Raquel. And she is suing Dr. Dre for lost wages as well as punitive damages she stemmed from being
bullied. I thought her name was Rachel.
It's definitely Raquel.
It's Raquel?
It's Rachel.
It's
Raquel. Oh, damn.
Well, whatever. It says it Raquel and then it says Rachel. I don't know.
She shouldn't have hired
it. Rachel is Raquel.
Whatever. I'm she shouldn't have got hired because of that name. So whoever wrote this has to get it right.
Whatever.
But anyway, so the nanny worked for Dre for about 13 months and she was treated harshly and unfairly by other housekeepers at the home. And according to her, they were jealous of her work ethic and would dump their workload on her. And it put so much anxiety in her that her she had burning pain in her neck, arms, and back. And eventually developed so much anxiety that she had hard trouble breathing one of those nights and landed in the hospital. And pretty much, she said she was fired while at the hospital for a panic attack. And she lost her... Guess how much she was getting paid a week?
I heard it was good bread.
Almost $1,900
a week. She better get her some damn Ben Gay and suck it up.
Like, but she got fired. And now she's suing them. Do you think that they should get paid or she should get paid?
That she should get paid because she got bullied after she complained about working too much and she's getting paid a good check? Go sit down.
What Jimm said.
So crazy shit has been happening in the airports lately. So pretty much, guess what happened? So a passenger allegedly choked a woman for reclining her seat too far back.
I would have too.
What?
Them seats, listen, we on an airplane, I'm already slick, claustrophobic, ain't all that space, and it ain't gonna work, you all in my space.
Yeah, that's pretty drastic. That's pretty drastic.
And I'm pretty sure she probably asked her to put the seat up.
Alright, so listen, so what happened was, she claimed that she was choked because the guy behind her was not feeling her chair all up in his face. So the altercation got so bad that the pilot had to stop the route from San Francisco and bring their, bring their crazy asses back to L.A. And the pilot told air traffic control, evidently we got two passengers who are in a physical altercation, and so we need to turn around and get back to L.A. So when they landed, they were detained for questioning, but no arrests were made. And the other 136 passengers had to get put on another plane and didn't get to where they had to get to for another 5 hours. Now, you best believe I'll be getting some money or a free trip or something.
But it's common courtesy. Like, you take people into consideration, especially on a small-ass airplane. Like, don't be leaning on me and you next to me in the next seat. Don't have your body all in my chair space and shit. Like, it don't work like that.
But anyway, all right. So, apparently, Kevin Hart was involved in a security strip club scuffle that left the waitress broke and pissed off. So they were leaving a strip club, and pretty much Kevin's, you know, first of all, he's not even that big to be having all these big-ass security guards, right? So his big-ass security guards were trying to push people out the way or whatever so they wouldn't get close to him leaving, you know what I'm saying, the strip club.
Right.
So then the strip club's security people, they got, you know, I guess feeling some type of way. So they started pushing back, and it ended into a scuffle. And so Kevin quickly got to the car, but didn't pay the $65 bill to the waitress, right? And so she tried to run to the car, but they took off.
So she's mad because she didn't get her $65.
I mean, I would be mad too.
I would as a server, and it was Kevin Hart, and he didn't tip me, and yeah, I feel kind of like.
I mean, it's only $65.
Yeah.
But then the owner had sit there and said, "Oh, well, it's okay. Kevin Hart's a good person, or whatever." And Kevin Hart, he actually tweeted today talking about the situation. He was like, "That's not what happened, and I did tip her," or something like that. But he said it in a funny way, which was, you know, whatever. I don't believe it.
Yeah.
But whatever. We'll see.
People want their 5 minutes of fame. You know, we just talked about her, so she's being talked about worldwide. So
I guess so.
That's her 5 minutes.
For bookings, that's gonna be on her Instagram.
The girl who didn't get tipped.
And again, shout out, happy birthday to Snoop Dogg. All right, so listen, y'all. The question of the day is: what is the most common lie you tell? And then the number is 404-334-0380. Again, that's 404-334-0380. And I'm surprised. I kind of want to hear what other people gonna have to say, because I feel like a lot of people are gonna have to say something related to sex.
Yeah.
I think so. Everybody lies about
so
sex.
Big, babe.
No. So, for everybody looking for a job, of course, the holiday season is coming up, so I know everybody's trying to get on that grind, especially with tax season come up.
Just trying to get a little bit of money. That money.
Right, but FedEx Express, they are hiring for a courier, and they posted this 4 hours ago on Indeed.com. And the pay is $17 an hour, so that's pretty good bread for, you know.
That's just damn good bread. Is it full-time or part-time?
I think it's full-time.
Y'all better get your resumes
up. It has to be that much.
Yeah.
Yeah, seriously.
Let them know what a courier is.
It's pretty much somebody who delivers everything.
Hey, thank you. Thank you for that, Miss Educated Woman.
You know, okay, thank you. And you pretty much have to be able to provide efficient and safe delivery and pickup of packages and documents.
Even in the hood.
Right, yep. Even when Shanika and them cut you off.
And when they got pit bulls at the door and at the gate waiting for you.
Right. I wish somebody had done that for us. Somebody stole our internet.
We're not going to talk about that.
Won't you at that day?
We don't have
for some people looking for a part-time job, Build-A-Bear Workshop is hiring, and they're located in Atlanta, Georgia, and other locations as well. And they're looking for somebody who has retail experience. So if you're a high school student or whatever, you just want to get that part-time jizz
knob. And want to know how to build a bear, you go on to Build-A-Bear.
Oh, Build-A-Bear, that's so cute. UPS is looking for a driver in Johns Creek, Georgia. And let me see, in the Department of Veteran Affairs, They're looking for a human resource specialist paying $73,000 to $93,000 a year.
Yeah,
and they're located in Decatur, Georgia.
I submitted to that one.
See, and that was posted 24 hours ago. And all these are recently posted. So y'all make sure y'all definitely get on that Indeed.com.
That's what's up. Well, I got some castings for everyone in the world who doesn't want to work a 9-to-5 like me. Hilton casting right now, good opportunity for the people casting male and female extras, all ethnicities, 25 to 50s, $200 per 12 hours, so overtime after 12 hours or whatever, but it's for a commercial for a retailer, Aaron's. You remember Aaron's? I think it's like a store where you get
like a furniture store?
Yeah, that's what I meant. That's what I was
like,
saying. When I thought of errands, I thought of dishwasher. But either way, you want to be in a commercial. $200 per 12 hours. You're probably going to work 14 hours, so 2 hours of overtime is always
ideal. For an errands commercial?
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
I mean, it's a whole day. But anywho, they want a lot of extras. So I think it's going to be like 12 extras per hour or whatever. But anywho, this is for tomorrow, Atlanta, Georgia. Tentative call time is probably going to be in the morning, 7:30 a.m. ideally. You must be available for up to 12 hours filming regardless. So if you're there for 12 hours, there's no like at 10 hours, oh, I've been here all day, I got to go pick up my daughter. Nah, you won't get paid. You're just going to have wasted like...
Wow.
That time, for real.
That's
and they're serious about it. But anywho, go to HiltonCasting.com/submissions/extras and make sure you list Aaron's rental commercial as your subject. Let's see, background cast in Atlanta is looking for some people. Looking for extras to work tomorrow in downtown Atlanta. This is for Atlanta locals only. Make sure in the subject line you put day 3 town folk with bikes. They're looking for people with bikes, ideally. Motorcycles, regular bicycles, you know, as long as it's a bike. Make sure, again, you submit your name, your age, your phone, your height, your weight, and all your clothes and size to containmentextras@gmail.com. I think that's actually going to be good because they're looking for a lot of people for containment right now. Let's see what else they're looking
for
tomorrow.
Is that a show?
I don't know if it's a show or a movie. I haven't worked on it yet. But ideally, get down there and find out. And somebody let me know, okay? All right, let's move on. For tomorrow, we're looking for fresh faces. Male fresh faces, extras, ages 18 to 21, to pass for high school students, job types, clean shaven, basically no facial hair. We want you to look like a child, okay? Morning call time, please email us a recent picture, age, height, weight, and number to fistfightextras@gmail.com. And in the subject line, put Wednesday, October 21st. And for my last one, I got CL Casting Powers. You know somebody that works for Powers,
yeah,
right?
I do.
Yeah, I submitted. They had this casting a few weeks ago, which was $500 for 8 hours to be in a scene butt-ass naked. They want,
hey, okay.
And you had to submit the birthday suit. I didn't get picked, but you know.
Why?
I didn't.
What, you sent your naked pictures?
Nah, they didn't ask for naked pictures. They just said submit pictures, you know. And if you are comfortable, you're going to sign a waiver, but it's $500 per 8 hours to be, you know, in the birthday suit if you're comfortable with it. But that's passed. But basically, Powers right now is looking for young and attractive Caucasian women, 18 to 30, to work on Thursday, October 22nd. It's a show right now. I think it's like Heroes, kind of like a spinoff or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But it's $80 per 8 hours. Most likely you're gonna work 12 hours, so the extra hours of overtime is definitely gonna do justice. Full name, pictures, phone number, age, height, size, shoe size, all that good stuff. And the subject, put Lady Hotness 1022 to Powers S2@Rose R-O-S-E Lock L-O-C-K-E casting.com. And, stay great, people. Remember, like I told you last time, stay updated with your pictures. If you're going out...
Whatever. You can follow me at They Call Me Chief on IG and Twitter. It's Chief_E. Snapchat is the same thing.
And you guys can follow me on everything followable. This guy, Jimm, J-I-M-M. That's Snapchat, that's Facebook, that's Instagram, that's all that great stuff.
You can follow me on everything followable also. Turn up T-U-R-N-U-U-P, and then on Snapchat, just throw a DJ on top of it.
Tea time, so if you want to call in, it's 404-334-0380.
Yeah.
And so this story is a little crazy today, so my girl Yasmin...
Hold on. For all those who don't know what Spill the Tea is, it's when people come to Chief in secrecy and
no,
she puts
it's
your
not
shit
that.
On blast
no,
for
that's...
the world to hear.
No, that's not what it is.
It's alright. Didn't Chi Chi come to you? What's her name, Chi Chi?
Her name is Yasmin.
Oh, I was close.
And she wanted advice. Like,
yeah. Oh, yeah,
like,
by the way, last week, how'd that going out?
Yeah.
She's still
with him?
I don't know. That's a whole different situation. But anyway, but back to this Spill the Tea today. So Yasmin, she pretty much has been with her boyfriend for the past 3 years, right? And so, but she recently suspected that he was cheating on her. Or, like, doing something because he became very distant. And especially when he came to the house, it was like a different odd vibe. It's like he didn't want to really be there a lot.
Right.
So, pretty much, she came home one night and she went to her roommate's room and she saw him, her boyfriend, and her roommate.
Damn.
And the worst part was, her roommate is a guy.
Oh. I'm mad I missed all that. I didn't hear anything. I was just talking to you.
All right, so basically, she's just like, she doesn't know what
she's got all these dramatic gay stories.
No, but so she was, obviously she was distraught, and so she hasn't been to the house since. And the problem is they both have their name on the lease. So it's not like she can tell him to get out, or it's not like she can leave.
She should just pay the brand to get out.
You think so?
Or get him out.
Yeah.
Or kick the roommate out or something.
And I was like, oh gosh. And I was like, well, how long do you think it's been going on? And she was just like, I don't know, and I don't even... She was like, she wanted to kill her roommate. But that's the first thing I would do. I would kill both of them. Like, you're not going to do that. First of all, this
is
so
disrespectful. Are you promoting violence, Jimm?
No, I'm not. I'm just saying, like, I didn't say kill, like, violently, but I'm saying, like...
Just kill lightly.
All right, we got to call her.
We got to call her. Call her, you're live.
Yo, what's up? Who is this and where you calling from?
This is Dead Fresh Eddie coffee team.
Hey, Dead Fresh Eddie. Hey,
oh,
what's
Dead
up?
Fresh, what's up, boy?
Hey, how you doing? Hey, man, we definitely got to play your track. Hey, listen, I got a question for you.
Okay.
What is the most common thing you lie about?
The most common thing I lie about?
Yeah.
I'm 100,
really. Dang, everybody says the same thing.
Yeah.
Okay, what's a white lie you like to tell? Or you tell a lie?
Yeah, I was saying somebody asked me money, and I was like, I'm broke.
True.
Hey, and you had any shout-outs you want to give?
Oh, yeah, just shout-out to Baby Simpson. I just was calling in and so low. Shout-out to Snap Clique, turn up.
Hey, thank you so much, man. I gotta hit you up. So we definitely gotta get together. Make sure y'all follow Dead Fresh Eddie. Give me your IG one time.
@DL_Eddie.
All right, it is what it is. Thank you so much for calling in.
Yeah, y'all follow me.
All right. Hey, he was dope. Like, yeah, he definitely, he was in the Street Execs Who Got the Juice in the finals, and he definitely piped up. But that's my nigga, though. That's my nigga. Thank you so much for calling in. And, y'all, so basically, back to this real tea. So, I don't know, but I wasn't saying that I would promote violence. I'm just saying that, first of all, if you're my friend, and you know that's my man, and then, you know, like, that's some trifling ass shit.
Yeah,
and then,
yeah.
And then, it's even more trifling for her dude to do that, too. Like, it's just, wrap it up, everybody.
Wrap it up. And don't sleep with your best friend's friends and best friend's friend's best friends.
Right. Like anybody close to you, my nigga.
Yeah.
So anyway, we're about to get into another music break, but we got Poe Nevada coming up. Make sure y'all stay tuned. We got Poe Nevada in the building.
What time is Poe Nevada in the building?
Yeah, you can cuss.
Yeah, we grown here, bro.
Internet new.
And we got Turn Up in the building as well.
What up?
And, so, obviously, thank you so much for coming through.
No doubt, man. It was a little hassle to get here. My GPS fucking up, but I got here. Oh, yeah.
You and me both, bro.
That's all that matters. When you show up, you show up.
Where can we follow you at?
IG, Poe Nevada, PoeNevada. Twitter, Poe Nevada 4K. That's basically it, where you can find me.
And where are you from?
I'm from Atlanta, Decatur, Georgia.
So where did you get the name Poe Nevada from?
Right. Poe. Shit, my like football name was like Poncho.
Wait, why?
Because they used to call me Poncho, but it just always stuck with me. And so, shit, basically we've stuck with my homeboys like everybody changed to Poe. P.O. And I dropped my first tape with DJ Icebreaker, P.O. And so, I just gained it on my own Poe. And the Nevada side, and because I used to work at UPS, I used to be in a truck, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Part time in Doraville, and shit, I was like, I'm always in the Nevada truck, not Poland. I put a poll out, but I'm gonna go phone about it. Just
hold on a second. Caller.
We got caller.
You're live.
What up? This your homegirl, Cece.
Hey, Cece. What's up, girl?
I want to give a shout out to the Faded Radio Show. I've been tuning in to y'all for the past couple weeks.
Hey, we appreciate you, Cece.
Hey, girl, you want to give any shout outs to your homegirls or anything? Sure.
Tell us your gram. Tell us your gram.
Yeah, CC on Instagram, CC on Snapchat, everything. But I was calling in
because
I was on the IG and they said I could get a free photo shoot. I
want to
see how that works.
Oh, what?
I see you guys.
You want a free photo
shoot?
Okay, so
Snapchat. We got to check
the Instagram. We got to cover.
Yeah, we got to make sure you beautiful.
We got some terms and details. Yeah, so
we got to make sure you beautiful.
I just fuck with it.
Now, SnapClique, he going to make sure you give us the information or whatever. And SnapClique, he's going to hand all the information out because he's the one who's going to be taking pictures. Yeah, all right, so, Poe, obviously, so how long have you been making music? And obviously, do you rap, do you produce?
Yeah, I produce it a little bit, but I'm not really into that right now in my life. I'm just into, like, the lyricism. I started doing this shit for, like, since I was young, man. So I focus on the lyricism and trying to get it right.
So, what inspired you to get into music?
Hello?
My grandma.
Okay. Yeah.
Hold on a second.
So that's where you get your inspiration from?
Yeah.
Hold on, she called back. Calling you live.
Yo, Bang Bang, I just wanted to give a shout out for home and congratulations on
Tokyo.
Oh, that's what's up.
Bang Bang.
Oh, Tokyo. Hey, Tokyo. I'm about to Tokyo. Tokyo, go ahead.
Shoot.
Thank you.
Alright, now you stay up.
We might have to play this. Play her song and shit.
All right, yeah, and where can we follow you at?
I know it. It's
I can't hear you well.
Where can we follow you at? What's your IG?
Oh, at Tokyo Bang Bang on Instagram and Twitter.
All right,
you better plug yourself.
All right, now.
All right, thank you, girl, so much for calling in. All right, so I know you have a performance tonight, and you have a couple this week.
Yeah, I'm trying to stay low though, man. But I got a couple of performances tonight, and I think my last show is gonna be this year is gonna be 11 November the 5th. So I want everybody to come out and check that out.
And where's it at?
It's gonna be at department store in Edgewood.
Okay.
Yeah, like
so yeah, it's a little lit spot. It's kind of trendy and shit like that. But we're gonna do it right there, and that's gonna be the end of the year. And you know, we're gonna come back next year stronger.
That's what's up.
Okay. Yeah. So did you I know A3C had just passed. Were you out there performing?
Yeah, we was out there. I just got a new job, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's about music, but it's also about staying down for yourself and your fam.
Yeah, we had said that earlier.
Yeah, you gotta be about the family and what you
gotta have a balance. You gotta balance it all out. So, I mean, I'm blessed by God to get a new job. So, I was only out there for 2 days, but in them 2 days, I talked to the people I need to talk to.
Okay.
I had two shows, like, two late shows, and you know what I'm saying? That shit was good.
Okay, and we about to get into the first song. It's called On Me, and it's by Pony Bonner. Can you tell us about this real quick?
This is just like some shit I've been performing around Atlanta. So if you see me perform in Atlanta, you know how this shit rock. So now you get to hear it live, just without all the hollering and hype shit. Yeah. You get a real music. Let's get it.
Yeah, got that reggae feel to it.
In my pocket, make them racks come out. I mean, her ass so colossus, make them racks come out. I'm still sipping on some scissors, got swishers, got pictures. Everything right here, you can leave your nigga. Well, how we do is jill, we don't steal it. Well, back to the ball with my killers. Even my acquaintance, what you up like it's raining. My new bitch don't steal, but best believe she's staying. So I can't go back broke. I'm a heck of an aimless. Hey, yo,
girl.
Rolling up swishes on the Sunday, yeah. Trying to get paid more than one way.
can't trust everybody, that's what a G told me. It don't throw salt in your game, Angelina Jolie. Holy shit, I go ham, how I roast beef. On the paper chase till I got so feet. But I stay low-key, high all the time, I need more weed.
What?
And codeine, that's my daily protein.
On cruise control, we roll and roll. Let's smoke some more and get higher.
Get out,
higher.
There go.
No crash and burn, we live in love. Buck stems, no steep, blow that fire.
Anyway, it's your favorite homegirl, Chief. You're listening to Fader Radio, and you just heard On Me and On Fire, and that was by Poe Nevada, and that was on his latest project called Summertime.
He got a smooth sound, smoking music.
It was really different, like, it was definitely different from what we hear, especially on these streets. Everybody's kind of, you know what I'm saying, like, on that same type of wave.
That twerk music.
Mm-hmm.
Or that crunk music.
Trap music.
Trap music. It's a bunch of that kind of music.
James, not that old. Crunk music.
Crunk.
So, let me ask you this. So, like, how important, obviously, is it to make yourself stand out, especially like in the rap game, especially even in Atlanta, period?
Well, I'm not even trying to stand out no more. It's just about just keep making my music better. Like, you know what I'm saying? Just relate to real niggas and ladies that's really out here grinding and shit like that. So that's basically what I'm trying to represent. I would love to represent that, you know what I'm saying? That real nigga, not even a street nigga, but just a real nigga, a real man. Real guy out here taking care of business. Like, he represents taking care of business. Oh, that's why niggas fuck with him. That's why bitches fuck with him.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm trying to do.
So who's your favorite artist?
Outkast.
Okay.
Pimp C.
Okay.
8-Ball MJG. Big Mo.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of Southern artists. I'm Southern based. Like, you know, I'm Southern based. I'm straight from the South. So, Ludacris. You know what I'm saying? Like, T.I., those are the people that I rock with, and Snoop Dogg.
Okay. So, like, what do you think about the state of music now?
It is what it is. You got to remember, you know what I'm saying, we got Kilo Ali, man. He really doing the same shit that we always know. Kilo Ali was doing some crazy shit. So, this Young Thug and this, that's just a evolution of what, you know what I'm saying?
It's like an evolution. Interpretation.
Yeah, it's an evolution. We've been that. We've been that. You know what I'm saying? That, and you know this, man. Shit,
yeah.
Kilo Ali is doing. Young Thug, my bestie. It's the same thing, right?
Yeah.
And you got your real rap. You know what I'm saying? You got your real R&B music from the 8. So we just we're a melting pot. You know what I'm saying? We got everything.
I said that when I first moved out here. Nobody I know from Atlanta is from Atlanta.
I'm from Atlanta. I'm from Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? I'm from Decatur, Georgia. I'm from Stone Mountain, Reading that Road. I'm from all that. You know, it's Zone 60.
Yeah, I'm from Massachusetts. She's from South Carolina.
So, what school you went to?
Decatur High School.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so where do you see yourself in the next year or so?
Next year or so, I see myself dressing nicely. More in my step. More money in my pocket, you know, better outlook on life financially, and just being able to do what I want to do without having to worry about a job.
Okay.
That's where I will be next year.
Optimism is key.
Yeah, that's where I will be next year.
Where you see yourself in 5 years?
Shit, times five over that.
that's what's up.
All right, well, I know we want to kick into the freestyle real quick because we also have the song Mercury Cruising and This That.
Yeah.
We're going to get into that, the last song with Nisha Knight. She was on here a couple weeks ago. Definitely, definitely dope.
The energy.
Yep, definitely dope artist. And I know y'all have a couple tracks together, right?
Yeah, hey, she brings fucking energy out of me.
Yeah.
Shit, when I'm on stage, I'm more, you see, I'm relaxed now. I've got some smoke, but when we're on stage, we doing work. That's work. You know what I'm saying? That's working. You know what I'm saying? So,
Chief, you going freestyle too?
No.
I
can
freestyle.
Y'all know I'm freestyle.
All right, Poe Nevada.
Hey.
Oh, this is a freestyle. This is why I freestyle.
Yeah, this one.
Turn it up. All right. Turn it up. turn it up like my DJ. Nigga, when I spit, y'all hoes be like replay. Nigga, I'm this shit, no need to relay. Cause I'm on the track, fuck a nigga at, how he at, I'ma cut his back. But I don't do that, I let you see my fist though. Shit, my fist glow, shit, my wrist, whoa. And your bitch know, and her clit know. Shit, I get her so wet, that shit, her clit know. Shit, no, you ain't gonna stop me, I'm on shit go. Let's get it, let's get it, let's get it, let's get it, let's get it. Hey, I'm just freestyling, I'm just freestyling. Yo, this ain't Cold Nevada. I am your...
You about to get it?
I can't rap. I'm about to try. I can't rap, but I'm here on the track. Spit words we know, lay them down real flat. Like a flat line.
Yeah, you should just stay where you was at. Sure. But anyway, before we get into that, so Mercury Cruising, what is that about?
Mercury Cruising is, I made that song when I was driving to New York City. I performed at SOBs, and it was just about, you know what I'm saying, me and just Mercury Cruising just chilling. Me and my weed ain't got down on some of my car. That's how we did it. So I just dedicated that song to that. So that's what Mercury Cruising is.
So would you say you perform the most or the best when you're high?
I've done it. Shit, I don't know, man. When you high, you just up there. When you sober, you think, yeah. The only thing that we do is keep you from thinking about the mishaps or keep you overthinking instead of just genuinely going out there and just
doing it,
being you. And that's what you can't be scared of. That you want to know how you set yourself apart. You set yourself apart by just being you and don't give a fuck when nobody think about you, for real. Like, just do you. And really gonna respect that shit, man. That's how it is.
That's for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. 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 Late night chillin' with the windows down. Just to ease my mind, I smoke a pound. I be damned if a nigga tell you about me. Cause they don't know the half, cause they not me. My old lady crazy, and some doubt me. Story of my life, turn wrong the ride. If I'm wrong tonight by fucking your old lady, say what? Either I'm sorry or I'm crazy, okay. But your hoe keep resting on my dick like she lazy. Make salad like my nigga skipping them. Something like Drake but way less estrogen. I'm just trying to be successful. Say what? But man, this shit is stressful. Shorty in my whip, in my hands, that's the brushful. One hand whipping, getting hit, I'm so careful. You know what I be doing, I be rolling up, chilling in my Mercury Cruising. Chilling in my Mercury.
And thank you so much for coming in. Do you want to give any final shout outs before we go?
Nah, we good. I like to give a shout out to God. Thank you for everything that you blessed me with. I like to give a shout out to the A, Atlanta, Decatur, Georgia, everybody in here. This team turned up. My favorite homegirl, my boy Slimmy Jimmy over here, Snap, and God bless everybody, and hey, support me, I'm Poe motherfucking Nevada, let's get it, where else the truth coming soon.
Alright, and the last song we're going to play is This Is That, and shout out to Soul Cold Affair, they up next, and thank y'all so much for tuning in to another episode of Faded Radio, every Tuesdays. 7 to 9. Make sure y'all subscribe to our YouTube page, Faded Radio Show. Make sure y'all do that. Follow Poe at Poe Nevada, IG, everything else. And they call me Chief. What's up? SnapClique IG. Cool.
I'm in the love trap.